Hi guys, this video is for the Unit 1. It's an introduction to the narrative paper that you guys will be writing. So I just want to go over a couple of main points about your paper, hopefully to clear up any type of confusion that you might have. First of all, this is a narrative. So that literally means you are trying to tell a story. So that means that you need to use a plot diagram as your reference. What's the plot diagram? Maybe you remember it kind of looks like a hill. The first part is the exposition. Okay, that's the introduction. This is where you give the setting. Remember, setting is time and place. So maybe you might indicate that, oh, it is, you know, spring of 2012. Something like that. You set up the setting. You might describe the setting if it's a specific location. This is probably where we'll be introduced to the characters, and if there's going to be any type of conflict or something that arises within the story, this might be where you introduce the conflict. Next, going up the hills, the rising action. This is when you have the unfolding of events. This is when you have the unfolding of the conflict, or the more of the introduction to the conflict. It's usually sequential or in chronological order. So remember, narratives, stories, which means you're going to be having time flow. You're going to be having time transitions. So like in the morning, after lunch, before school, those might be the type of words that you use to connect your thoughts and your ideas. Then you have the climax. And the climax, that's the top of the action. That's the turning point. I always like to say this is the part in the movie where the music is going crazy. You know that part where you're like, oh boy, because it's like really emotional. It's really a tense moment. This is when everything could change for that main character, right? Then you've got the falling action. And this is where you just have those events that's leading up to the conclusion. You know, the whole, you're getting ready to wrap things up, things of that nature. It's just, it's coming down to a close. And then, of course, there's the close, the resolution. And this is the end result. It's how it all concludes. So this is when the main character, you know, takes home the love of their life, you know, whatever it is, it's the conclusion. And often this is where the moral of the story is. So if your paper is on, you know, a time in your life where you learn something about yourself, the resolution will be where you're really reflecting on that and how that particular event actually meant something to you and how that actually taught you something about yourself. You know, narratives are not always, you know, linear, meaning they might be non-linear, meaning they might play around with flashback and flash forward, those kinds of things. I don't mind if you play around with that. If you want to, you don't have to. It's definitely not required. But if you do, just make sure that you don't confuse your readers. Make it clear so we know, okay, we're in a flashback, or, you know, we've got some sort of foreshadowing or something happening. So, you know, again, linear or non-linear is up to you. Also, if you want to use first person or second person, that's up to you. I wouldn't say second person, actually, I'd say third person. So maybe you want to apply, you know, for some reason, if you want to refer to yourself in the third person, he, she, by your name or something, that's fine. But I do expect that most of you will be using I or first person. Also, description is key. So describe characters, describe settings, use figurative language, okay? What does that mean? You can always look that up, but you know, similes, metaphors, you know, vivid verbs, things of that nature, action verbs, instead of just saying I sat down, I plopped down. Think about how you can use very descriptive words that create an image for your reader. Finally, this is 3 pages long, so think about how you can add length. Can you add more to the story? Maybe you can add some more back information or backstory in the exposition before you actually get into the telling of the story. Maybe you might have a couple paragraphs of exposition. Maybe you might be able to add to the rising action. Maybe there's some more information you can give. Maybe the rising action can be a couple paragraphs and versus each part of the plot diagram being a specific or one paragraph. And also, you know, just adding description. If you mention your mother in a particular scene, why not describe her? What did your mother look like at that time? Did she have a bonnet on her head? You know, what was going on at that case in that particular particular situation and can you describe it? And of course, you can also add to the settings. So not just saying that it was a spring day in 2012, you can actually describe what that day looked like, what it felt like, thinking about all of the senses, again, that figurative language, you know, how did it look? How did it smell? What did you hear? By chance, was it something, could you have tasted something, you know, and what were you able to touch? So thinking about just even appealing to the five senses in order to help create an image for the reader. So just know, you're telling a story, draw us in, describe it to us, act like you're telling the most interesting story in the world to your best of friends, and make sure that story tells us something about what you learned about yourself. Let me know if you have any questions. Have a good one.